Hello everyone, SMA Watts. We're about to really begin our let's play of MicroProse's Magic the Gathering from the 90s. Last video was our little intro, showed you what we're playing, laid down some of the rules we're going to follow. Those rules will get more, I'll add more as we get more powerful decks, basically to keep us from just blowing the game away. Couple quick notes. So this Ankh-Yu is our life total. Getting mana links as quest rewards will increase the amount of life we start each duel with. Food is sort of only mildly important. It lets us move fast. Like, when you are hungry, you will move slower. Gold is what we use to buy cards. This tells us what our collection is. These are the world magics, which are powered by amulets, which are one of the other currencies for getting cards. Right now, I think we have the teleport to random place spell, which is the blue one. And this down here is for random trinkets. So let's double check this. Oh yeah, none of this is like giant tortoise is almost. That's a big a playable. All right, begin a quest. Take this message south to my brother, the keeper of Andor's Spire. He'll reward you with a white amulet. Sure. That Andor Spire? That is Andor Spire. White amulet. Trade black amulet for white cards. So the first white card we're going to be interested in is Swords to Plowshares, which I'm guessing, yeah, two. Wrath of God's going to be three. Summon. Guessing Sarah Angels are going to be two. Yeah. So we just don't have enough amulets to get anything worthwhile right now. Done. Buy cards. So he's got. What does this do? If Preordain was really a bad card. Begin a quest. Defeat the Mind Stealer, which has been menacing our village. Return here and I'll reward you with white cards. We'll try it. I'm not 100% sure this will actually work. You encounter another fiend, get. Well, there's a Library of Alexandria. We're going to duel the creature. We'll play first. All right, yeah, we'll go ahead blue line drawing. All right, this gives us a little bit more of a dueling space. All right, so we got kind of a janky draw. Okay, but we pulled a second island, which enables us to cast nothing in our hand. We really could use another. A third land will help. Right, so third land turns on Wall of Air. Yeah, one of the things that's interesting about this game is it is much more of a. It is. Less of a magic simulator and more of a role-playing game that uses magic as like its language. All right, well, we're gonna block that. And he's just gonna let us kill it. Okay. He's playing another Xenic Poltergeist. All right, I guess we play a Samite Healer. All right, so if he attacks with the Wall of Air, all right, well that's fine. Just ping it. All right, so let's play out a water elemental. one of our most powerful cards right now, which is a little sad. Right now we got the Prodigal Sorcerer Sandmite Healer combo, which is actually pretty significant. Alright, so we're going to swing with the Water Elemental. If he blocks with both Black Knights... I wasn't really expecting him... Alright, so kill that. And prevent one of the damage. And we wipe his board. Like I said, the computer's a little special. Alright, so off the bat, we're going to kill this product, his, Frozen Shade before he gets to do anything with it. Swing in with our Water Elemental. And play another Sandmite Healer. I could have played an Unstable Mutation, but it's not a very good card. I mean, because if he just keeps playing blockers... Like, it's Unstable Mutation is really a card I want to play on evasive creatures. Like this ghost ship here. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and Unstable Mutation our Ghost Ship. Just because it gives us a much faster clock. Since he's basically dead this turn. Platter Island. And got there. We got a Scrubland, which is going to go right in our deck, and a Library of Alexandria, which is going to go right in our deck, and a Winter Orb. That's pretty darn good. Found a Swamp. So, edit deck. So the Scrubland goes in, and we'll pull out one of our swamps. Library of Alexandria goes in, and we'll pull out one of our islands, because nothing's, we don't have anything super heavily blue. I don't really want to go up to sword deck. What is that? 18 lands. I don't really want to go up to 19 lands, so yeah, we're going to... Let's, because there's a lot of, this game's really buggy. We're going to save it frequently. Are you a Mind Stealer? You're just a Seer. We will duel this Seer. Play first. Alright, did not get the Library of Alexandria draw. Play the Plains... I had a Zephyr Falcon. Oh, wait, no, I anti to Zephyr Falcon. Or no, he anti to She anti to Zephyr Falcon. Yep, Zephyr Falcon. I see your Zephyr Falcon, and I raise you a wall there. Which is a great early defensive creature. Like, this is one of those creatures they don't really make anymore. Because it's really, really just bad for limited. Distance it encourages a very dirtily style of play. Counterspelled. I didn't see that coming, I have to be honest. Ow. Well, if he has another unsummon, this could be a problem. Alright, we're gonna sit on our hand for a bit. Try and get our library online. Unsummon their own dude. Yeah, it's worth waiting the turn. Because just of how powerful Library of Alexandria is once it's online. Draw a card. Ghost ship. Play a swamp. I see a ghost ship and raise you a ghost ship. I think the Unholy Strength is the right call here. It means if he wants to block his ghost ship with mine, he has to regenerate it. Another ghost ship. Scrubland. Let's attack. Can't regenerate it right now. Speed bumps it. Alright. Bahamodi Jin. Another ghost ship. So I guess we'll play a planes, draw a card. Alright, let's attack. Triple blocking. Alright, well, we'll kill one of them. I did not really anticipate that play. Move our library. Should have unstable mutated the, Alright, Wheel of Fortune, Time Walk. I think we just actually need the cards right now. You get extra gold. Alright. Buy cards, what do you got for me? Disenchant's useful, but not yet. In long ago ages, some cities began to hoard their magics. The wise men of these cities searched for a champion throughout dark days. When your talent was discovered, they agreed to pool the remaining bits of power in an attempt to unseat Arzakhan and his evil magics. Two of these cities which have links are Mandrake Tavern and Zephyrhaven. Thanks. What did that even mean? Alright. Are you a mind stealer? You are a mind stealer. I shall duel the mind stealer. Well, turn one Library of Alexandria will rarely lose. Draw a card. Pump. You playing my deck? Nope. Spell Warstone. Alright, so move Library of Alexandria over here so that I can island. Draw a card. Play my dirtily 2/1. Back in the days when a 2-mana 2/1 in black needed a drawback. Alright. Unholy Strength, a little rough. I guess we throw our wall away. Draw a card. Alright, we'll just get saucy with this guy. I think we're gonna lose this one. Yeah, we're dead. I think we're just dead here. We lost our Phantasmal Monster. It makes me sad. And we... What is the power rating of Onosai Vulture? Well, they're a 1/1. I found a bad moon. Which one is this? That's so bad. Let's duel the Mindseer again. Well, we have a very powerful card, at least, in our hand. Which, if I'm stealing a 2/2 flying regenerator, I'm going to be a little sad. And prevent one of the damage. Double click. I'm taking your guy. And attacking you for 3. This actually represents a really quick clock, actually. Well, you're way too late to the party, Library. But... Second for 8. Alright, so now he needs to play 2 blockers. We control magic to back his own tapped guy. But that won us the game. Well, that's a lot of cards. All common, kind of crappy. But I'm going to take the cards. What card of your choice? I think we just take Wrath of God. Not but the Guild Lords have seen as Arzakhan. So nothing said of the monster can be trusted. It is rumored, however, that it has one fear, an ancient rival, the wizard Yordan. Unfortunately, it has been centuries since the two planeswalkers met and fought. Perhaps we're fortunate this rival's not here. It's likely he's as evil as Arzakhan. If you combine Amaru Kithkin with Howl from Beyond you already have, you can surprise your opponent with a 1-1 creature suddenly howling more damage than they originally expected. Yeah, but then I'd be playing Amaru Kithkin and Howl from Beyond. Alright. Zephyr Falcon in her deck. Yeah, and the Wrath of God. We'll take out a Brainwash for that. Alright, we're gonna save it. And I don't believe we've been to this town yet. What do you got for sale? Nothing I want. What's your quest? Take this message east to my brother, the keeper of Craig's Shrine. He will reward you with a green amulet. Let's duel the creature. I mean, there's no reason not to. But what does Living Artifact do again? Reach one damage dealt to you. It is not really a card. Go down to 3 to play your, I mean, this dragon's clearly got some stuff. And by stuff, I mean an Antlet. And back up to top, back up to its original life total. Alright, let's hold back on the off chance we actually do draw our library. I mean, technically it's only one card in our deck. We're equally likely to draw our Modi, which is 6 mana. Earthquake for 2, okay. Do you only get one corpse counter? I mean, his living artifact's kind of loaded now. No, it gets one for each. It's super regenerator, though. It can't regenerate from Wrath of God. Well, we drew our best card for if this thing eventually does play something worthwhile. grindy game. I mean, I'm guessing it eventually will play like a dragon. So we're now in serious trouble, because, like, if it plays something like Lightning Bolt, we're just dead. Or Hurricane for 4. I mean, the upside of it is the fact that we don't actually lose any life. Find a Grape Shot Catapult. I actually want to check the map, which means I think we need to go in here. See the map. Oh, we need to be going the other way. Derp. Trade a black amulet for a blue card. Nope. Well, it's two for our elemental. Through from underground sea. Two for control magic. Yeah, boomerang's not terrible, but let's hang on to our amulets. To release the world magic amulet of Swamplock from Nevermore Shrine. Sure, we'll get the we're no longer slowed in swamps. Okay, we'll deal the priestess. I tried to press F6 there to end my turn. Oh, that actually works, doesn't it? Because well, that merfolk's neutralized, but, I mean, it drains two cards out of their hand. Pikeman, gain a life. Wall of Swords. Oh, I have not played any white sources. Wow. I was like, I'm going to play my Sarah. Let's actually play some planes so I can play that Sarah. Whew. Alright, so if I make it a 6-5, I don't think the pikeman can block, because even though it has banding, they both have to be, I think all the blocks have to be legal. But a nice reverse damage will throw me off, won't it? Second Wall of Swords, and they both have banding. That is a weird restriction. All right. These cards all suck. Take the dungeon clue. Smoke's permanently in effect. Sure. Duel the priestess. Scrubland, I guess, first. I think my most important card is actually going to be Cursed Land. Unless they're playing my deck. In which case, Water Elemental will be the most important. Yeah, this looks like a mirror match. Dredge Skeletons, get in there. Alright, so Control Magic. That'd be the best card for him to play. Or his own Water Elemental. Let's see if we can get him to commit some more to the field before we wrath. But now we're forced to wrath. Ah, the good old Wrath of God, the I know something you don't know play. That's pretty much game no matter what he draws. There's nothing in my deck that can hastily kill me. So, yeah, we'll take these cards. And an amulet of each color. Duel the Witch. Throne of Bones is fine. Unfortunately, gaining life from our Dredge Skeleton's kind of annoying. I mean, I suppose it is the best way to just threaten their life total. You know, force them to act. We're in pretty good position here since we can just shoot the clay statue out of the way. Or just take it on the chin. I believe he gets the token anyways. He didn't have to be in play. Get in there, guys. Drain life and greed are definitely worth taking. Found a Howling Mine. Not like... You buy on Circle of Protection Black with Ash Dash you already have. You can do things that are kind of cool. Alright, see map. Alright, we're... actually, a good way away from... Alright, do you have anything worth buying? Health and Beyond? Animate Wall? No. Almost like, do you have anything that's not terrible? Yes. Alright, I must duel the Druid. Yeah, well, I'm feeling pretty confident. I mean, I did lose last time I had a first turn out library. I feel that was more of a fluke. I guess we're going to discard the Tundra Wolves. It's the lowest impact card we have in our hand. Scrubland. We'll draw on our opponent's turn. Island. Play another island. Attack for 5 in the air. Draw a card. Curse your land. One of those cards that's... The value of cards that do 1 damage go up significantly when your life totals are so low. Island. Draw a card. Water elemental. Yeah, we'll just block that. Yeah, I know I was gonna get giant growth, but... Though I did tap that wrong. Oh, and... Wow, I just... That was just dumb. Alright, well... Here, we'll take the dungeon clue. These are both terrible cards. Contains small white creatures. Right, buy cards. The regenerating thing? It's not really useful. But the dragon engine's actually not, just not good at that price. Alright, what's my hand? Two lands. You know, we're just going to keep our hand that has lands in it. Because while he could have mulled, while we could have mulled, our hand wasn't terrible. And I don't think a random seven's actually better for us. Though we do need some more dual lands. You know what, we'll just take the giant growth to the chin. We just have to hope he doesn't have another one. And since they didn't attack in, that seems like a fair bet. Also terrible cards, Dungeon Clue. Oh, it's right there. You know, this video is actually running a little long. I would like to get to the place we need to go. Oh. Map. Bag Shrine is actually south now. Sins is a sorcery to attack Zephyr Haven. You may buy... was it Black Amulets at the one place? Nothing worthwhile here. Let's actually sell some cards. Sell the Bad Moon. Sell the Brainwash. Actually, for the moment, let's just get to the shrine. Trade green amulets for any enchantment. I would like control magic. What do you have for sale? Green cards. We're not playing green. So, quick change to our deck. We're going to take out Merfolk of the Pearl Trident, add in control magic. And And we're going to take out one of our grudge skeletons and add in a grapeshot catapult. Alright, that's going to be it for this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you'll watch the next.